Today, I want to show you how an architect can use AI software to improve their design workflow. But first, let me tell you really quick what this is all about. So maybe some of you have heard of a website called Midjourney, which generates images from text prompts. A few years ago, a group of brilliant people got together and invented a code that could detect elements from an image and improve search results. So if I took a photo of my cat and uploaded it to Google, Google could search for similar cats. So while all these searches were taking place, a ton of information was being stored that connected images to specific words. Fast forward a few years later, another group of smart people got together and said, hey, we have all of this information that connects images to text. What if we try to do the opposite using artificial intelligence? I type a particular set of words and the AI machine will search the whole internet for images connected to those words and create a new image. Fast forward to today, and a couple of companies are testing this program out as we speak. And although it's still in beta, many already see it as the future. But how can architects use this? So let me try to explain how to use it as an architect, why this paints an exciting future for our workflow, and some examples of the things I have done, which, to be honest, I am truly excited to show you. So how to use it. So at the moment, Midjourney works through a Discord server, which is the place where you actually generate images. You type /imagine and then whatever you want to create. So for example, a photograph of the Roman Pantheon on Mars with dust. I waited a few seconds and this was the result. Now, they give me four different options in a low resolution. I can select any option to see on a larger detailed scale by clicking on U1, U2, U3, or U4, or I can also generate four more variations of each option. And if I don't like any of the options, I can develop a different seed by clicking here. I can also type the same prompt again, but maybe add more details. Midjourney indicates that you can be as specific or as vague as you want, but anything you leave out will be randomized. Being vague is a great way to get variety, but you may not get what you want. Try to be clear about any context or details that are important to you. So let's try to be a little bit more specific by typing maybe an ancient render of the Roman Pantheon located on Mars with dust, big crowd in the front, floating cypress trees, architecture in 8K, HD, and with cyberpunk style. And if I click on upscale, this is how the image will look. Midjourney encourages you to use specific keywords that can describe a feeling, a style, a reference artist, particular compositions, and also taking two well-defined concepts and combining them in strange ways. For example, psychedelic astronaut crew, or cyberpunk spaceship underwater. So let's try something different. Let's select a well-defined type of architecture, like a pyramid. Now let's choose a feeling we want to perceive in the image, like mystery. Next, let's choose a style. So maybe a dreamlike style. And finally, some reference artists. So let's go for artists like James Turrell, which I like very much, Norman Foster, and Albert Bierstadt. So the final prompt will look something like this: a mysterious twisted red pyramid in the snow designed by James Turrell, Albert Bierstadt, and Norman Foster with a dreamlike style. So these are the four images it generated. I'll make some variations on number four and upscale the third one. So as you can already imagine, the possibilities are endless. Still, suppose your vocabulary of verbs, nouns, reference artists, and ideas is limited. In that case, you will give more space for the AI to randomize your image, generating a more familiar image. So if we look into Instagram, ArtStation, blogs, etc., we can already see many artists that have created or generated really cool pieces. Still, many of these images look more or less the same in some cases, or are having some sort of Midjourney type of style. One way to avoid this is by having your own personal set of artists that inspire you and mixing them. If you type extremely famous and search artists, chances are you won't stand out that much. But if you combine different artists from many fields, you could get some exciting results. Now, I can already see the comments saying, all right, Steven, well, our jobs are finished. Computers are taking over completely. Or this is not art made by anyone. This is a ripoff of many artists. Or why will our clients need us now? And the way I think of it is as a design tool, as a starting point for your designs that can give you some visual ideas and help you precisely distinguish what your client can see. So let me explain. In a first scenario, you're at the beginning of a project. You have many ideas in mind, but not a clear visual yet of where to start. By placing some words together of the concepts you have in mind, you can get a set of images that can set a starting point for your design. As soon as you have this, you can take that image and start working on top of that. Or a second scenario, your client says they imagine a house in the woods that gives a sense of warmth with a modern vibe. Try exploring how these abstract words can be visualized and communicated to your client. Do they imagine warm color materials or a flat roof, a traditional type of cottage? By placing these abstract words into the AI, you can have an idea and maybe discuss these ideas with the client. Similar to what you would discuss if you had a material or reference mood board. The difference is that the mood board is already created with thousands of images in mind and no one exact image. Like Austin Kleon said, every new idea is just a mashup or a new remix of one or more previous ideas. Hence, your images are a mashup of what you choose to let into your prompt. In a third scenario, let's say you already have your architecture design, but still you're having trouble finding ways to represent it better. Well, this could be the perfect tool. You can grab some keywords from your design and mash them with two or more reference artists that you can imagine can represent it. I would suggest going for artists outside of architecture, maybe like photographers, visual artists, movie directors, painters, etc., and seeing what can come out of this. Now let me show you what I have created these last few days and how I will use this tool in the future. So I realized as I was generating different prompts that what can define, distinguish, or make your image stand out is your references and the craziness of your ideas. Typing in a house floating in the air inspired by Edward Hopper gives totally different results than a house floating in the air inspired by Christopher Nolan or Wes Anderson. The more references you mix, the more interesting it can get. Also, I had some fun exploring contradicting or challenging to explain concepts and placing them in the prompt generator. Prompts like building a facade made of trees, a skyscraper made of rammed earth, or a blue house covered in transparent plastic. Your results can also differ depending on the keywords you add towards the end. Some people have seen that adding the keywords realistic, render, 8K, blender, and high resolution generates different images as if they were not there. And in this sense, adding words like drawing, graphite paper, axonometric, and architecture drawing can steer you in a different direction altogether. So take into account that we are still very early into the software and things are constantly changing. The more images the AI has and the more they are tuned in with specific words, the better our prompts will, eventually be. Also, I have understood that they are already taking measures to prevent any sort of plagiarism, so artists can opt out maybe of being considered for these databases if they don't want their images being used. Also, these images are not entirely your property since this is open software. Anyone can take any of them and riff off or take them as inspiration to create their own art. In some sense, it makes the information available for everyone. It encourages users to be very specific about their references to avoid getting familiar images. If you want more information on Midjourney and how to sign up, there will be a link down below. And I want to hear from you and read your opinion on how this can influence architecture and architecture representation. Also, if you want more videos on this software, let me know. Comment down below and check out this playlist right here to learn more about architecture representation in general. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.